thirsty and 30.
Very clearly, I'm sure as a mother and daughter, you guys have broken the ice with each other. So we don't need to break the ice today. But to give you an overview, but you know what our usual breaking the ice moment pala is? Maybe you guys can chime in. What is your go-to flirting style?
Oh gosh.
That's our usual icebreaker. I would like to hear this pala.
Why don't we start with the veteran?
Okay.
What's my go-to flirting style? Oh my god!
Do you flirt, mom?
I mean, I'm just so I'm trying to think because it's been so long. I think ano lang, I'm kind of more open and more machika. I think yun lang. I can't really think of make gugu eyes ng ano, but yeah, I think I'm kind of more welcoming lang, and you know, yeah.
Okay.
How about you, Ricky May?
Oh, thank you so much. For me naman, I'm kind of badoy. You know, I'm kind of badoy. Like, I'm so torpe. Like, my friends get surprised, but I'm super torpe kasi. So, I always, like, play it cool. Especially, like, me, since, of course, as we know, I'm gay, I'm a lesbian. So, you don't know sometimes if, uy, this girl that I like, is she, parang, so kaya kami, or kasi, you know, I don't want to freak her out, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So for me, it's more of friendship first, and then if there are some sparks, then I'll put in a little like line or two.
Give us a line.
It's really lame. It's lame, and it's not my own line. But like, there was this one time. I'm so sorry, my girlfriend, if you're watching. This is like years ago that I said this line to someone. I met someone in the airport, and then it was a good vibe naman. And then we were flying to the same place coincidentally. So parang we talked, and then when we were actually coincidentally in the same plane. So parang like all the coincidences were there. So I walked up to her. We talked. Oh, so I'll see you. Maybe we'll see each other in this place. Mm-hmm. And then I was like, if I don't do it now, I might not see her on wherever we're going, diba? So I went up to her. I was like, hey, you forgot something. Your number. Tapos she gave me.
She gave it.
Yeah, but it's so baduy. It's so lame.
It worked.
Yeah, but
for
it
some
worked.
Reason, yeah.
True.
Oh, and first of all, that is like, years ago, you know, meeting someone in the airport and you can just go up to them. Nowadays, how can you go up to someone?
I'm telling you, Rick, gagawin ni Bea yan. Gagawin ni Bea.
Please try it. It might still work. It might still work.
I will write it in a paper and slip it in.
Oh, Bea, we got tips for flirting styles. Okay. So, ladies, our conversation, what we're going to do is we've divided it into three parts. What you learned from your mom, what mom learned from you, Rick, and what you discovered together. But before we dive in our conversation, we got an anonymous letter from one of our listeners. Bea, take it away.
Thank you for the cue. No, I love these anonymous letters. And of course, hearing the advice of our guests. So, dear CNB and Rick and Jackie Lou, I'm a 30-year-old gay man. It's been about 5 years since I've come out to my family. Their reactions to my coming out was really shock and anger. My dad wouldn't even talk to me for a while. My mom just cried every time she looked at me. The last 3 or so years, they've started to accept me for who I am. So I've started to become very open about the men I've been dating intentionally. Hindi naman ako malandi. My goal is to find a stable relationship that helps me grow. My current boyfriend I met at a book club. Honestly, we are just so in sync in all our interests. He's also a very nice Pinoy boy, and I think he could be the one. But my mom doesn't approve of him. Actually, just a bit of context, she hasn't approved of any boyfriend I've introduced to her. When I asked her why, she always replies, basta. How can I have a heart-to-heart talk with my mom, and how can I get her to be on my team with my current boyfriend? So, love, Mr.
Wow.
Bookworm. Yan. Who gusto wants to start? Basta. Tama yan. Palagi ko narinig yan sa mga nanay at tatay.
Sige, I'll go first. Ako siguro, since they've accepted him already, I think she should just keep trying with the mom. I think... Kasi like my daughter nga would always say, It's a process. I also had things before na kala ko tama, tapos Ricky May would get upset, but she would still always try and she would always do it out of love. Mom, hindi kasi ganito ito. So I would advise him to do the same, just to keep trying and siguro to not to think na hindi siya tanggap ng mom niya or hindi tanggap kung sino man. Siguro the mom is also going through some things that she still cannot, siguro still cannot tell him, or maybe she still has her own issues. So siguro for me, just to really keep trying and to feeling ko one of these days the mom will just finally say, okay, di ba? Okay na, if that's what you really like and if that's what makes you happy. So sige lang, just don't give up. For me lang, ha? Sige lang, just to keep trying and then just to be more patient. You know, a lot of things take time.
Yeah.
I like that. I agree.
How about you, Ricky?
How about you, Rick?
Grabe. I get so pressured with these questions because it's so like, I don't know. Hi, Mr. Bookworm, if you're watching. I hope you're okay. Mm-hmm. What I always say is that the first reaction of your parents or whoever you came out to, it's usually not the last. Because as we were talking offline earlier, I mentioned that, you know, even us as people of the LGBTQIA plus community, it's not like we know instantaneously, or sometimes we do, sometimes we don't, but you know, we also have our own way of processing things, like am I gay, am I bi, am I, you know, and whatever.
Yeah.
So if we as the individuals have that, you know, way of processing, what more the parents who are sometimes like blindsided, like, whoa, I di ko alam yon, di ba? So I would advise him to, you know, keep at it, Mr. Bookworm. It's super hard. It's so hard to be patient with someone who you love and you want to be accepted. It's so parang frustrating, and sometimes maybe you feel like you don't even want to try. But at the same time, like, I feel like you should continue trying. Sometimes people really take time and not everyone is blessed to have, you know, support right away. But oh my gosh, I'm so dal-dal, guys, sorry.
Okay lang yan.
Yeah, but at the same time, I also think that you shouldn't spread yourself too thin, because you know, you can't force someone to be ready.
Thirsty and 30.